Hello CSPro users, and welcome to CSPro video tutorial, Introduction to CAPI Data Entry. CSPro supports computer-assisted personal interviewing, CAPI, data entry. In CAPI, the interviewer enters responses as they occur. The interview is conducted face-to-face, and the entry application, sometimes called the instrument, determines the question order and performs editing of responses. CAPI offers a flexible approach to collecting data and can result in improved data quality and more efficient interviewing and processing. Creating good instruments requires training and experience on the same level as creating batch edit programs. In this tutorial, we will first review CAPI features and then create a CAPI application that will run on Windows and Android devices. Let's begin by looking at some of the CAPI features. These are question text, help text, multiple languages, response boxes, notes, support for partial save, customized branching, and immediate editing. Let's look at each of these features, beginning with question text. Customized text for each question can be displayed at the top of the entry form. Help text. A help hotkey, F2, can bring up customized help information for each field. Multiple languages. The CAPI entry application can be developed with question and help text in several languages. The interviewer can switch among languages as needed. Response boxes. During entry, a pick list of valid values for each question can be optionally displayed. These can make the interview go more smoothly. Notes. Interviewers can enter field-level notes when needed. Support for partial save. If an enumerator is unable to complete an interview, the enumerator can save the incomplete case by selecting Save Partial Case. The enumerator can then return later to the partially completed questionnaire and complete the interview. Customized branching. The entry application can determine on the fly which forms or questions to present based on the user's previous responses. This is accomplished through program logic. Immediate editing. Responses can be edited and errors or possible mistakes signaled to the interviewer. This can help improve data quality. Now that we have seen the features of CSPro, let's create a CAPI application. Open CSPro and select Create New Application. Click OK. This will be a CAPI Data Entry application. So click on CAPI Data Entry Application and click OK. Navigate to the folder where you wish to place the application and then name the application. I will give the application the name My CAPI _ intro. Click on Save. The next step is to add the dictionary and define the items in the dictionary. I will give the dictionary the same name as my application, My CAPI _ intro. Click OK. The dictionary does not exist yet, so I will create it. And now CSPro has given me a dictionary template. We add our items to the dictionary as we would any CSPro dictionary by entering the item, label, name, length, etc. for each item. This dictionary defines, in the ID section, the household ID, in the person record, a 20-character alpha field to enter a respondent name. The name can then be included in the CAPI question text. The sex, a single-digit numeric field with possible values of 1 for male and 2 for female. Relationship, a one-digit numeric field with possible values of 1 to 9 for up to 9 different relationships. Age, a three-digit numeric field allowing for ages 0 to 115. Literate, a single-digit numeric field with the possible values of 1 for literate and 2 for not literate. This is how our CSPro data dictionary will look when it is complete. Take time to review the dictionary. This is the dictionary we will be using for our application. Once the dictionary is complete, switch to the Forms tab by clicking on the Forms button on the toolbar. CSPro now presents you with a Forms template. Select Edit, Generate Forms. CSPro tells you that a new set of forms based on the input dictionary will be generated, and ask, do you want to continue? We'll say yes. And we will accept the defaults. Note for a CAPI, it is important that Use Extended Controls is checked. Click OK. CSPro has generated the form for household ID fields and for the person record. Note that the controls have a blue outline. These indicate an extended control. See the CSPro helps for more details on extended controls. The next step is to create the CAPI questions. Make sure the Forms tree is displayed by clicking on the Forms tab on the bottom of the screen. The CAPI question will appear in this area. Right-click on the item in the Forms tree and select View CAPI Question to bring up the dialog box to enter the CAPI question. Enter the CAPI question in this panel. This is the text that will appear on the device. Let's enter the question text for household ID. I will first add instruction to the enumerator. Enter the household ID. If items are not visible, make sure you click on the plus sign to make them visible. Note the formatting options. We can use them to change the formatting of the question text. For example, we can select and change instruction to the enumerator to italics. We can select and change the color. Here I select household ID and change it to red. I select household ID again and change it to bold. We can select and change the font. Here I will select enter the household ID and change the font to 20 point. Take some time to explore the various formatting options available to you for the CAPI question text. We will continue to enter the CAPI question for the remaining items. Let's now enter the question text for sex. Is dot 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 male or female? Question mark. We can use a fill to customize the question text. We do this by specifying the item name surrounded by percent marks. Here, instead of using dot dot dot, I will enter percent, name, closing percent, male or female. And I will change the color of name to make it red so we can easily identify it. And I do that by selecting the color button on the toolbar and choosing the color I wish to use. What appears here as name will be in bold red. when the question text appears to the enumerator, percent name will be replaced by the name that had been entered under name. In this example, if John Doe is entered for the name, the question text for sex will be, is John Doe male or female? We can continue down with the remaining variables by following the same procedure. Here we see the CAPI question text we will be using in our application. We will need a method to end the roster. The method we will use to complete the data entry for the household, that is ending the roster, and continue to the next household, is to leave the name field blank. That is, if the name is blank, ask the operator whether to continue with the roster or end the household roster. To do this, we will test to see if the name is empty. If the first option is selected, that is, if selection is equal to 1, then we continue with the household roster. Otherwise, we end the roster by using end group. This is how it will appear entering the names on the desktop. If we want to continue with this household, we would enter a new name. If we want to end this household and continue with the next one, we leave it blank. The except statement gives us our option of continuing or ending the household roster. I'm going to end it by clicking on End Household Roster, and this case is now complete. Now that we have written the code for our CSPro application, we are ready to transfer the application to our Android device and run the code. If CSPro is not already on the device, we install it on the device. We get CSPro from the Play Store. Once CSPro is installed, we transfer the application to the device. The steps for transferring an application to an Android device are 1. Create the PFF file if it does not already exist. 2. Create the pen file. 3. Copy the PFF and the pen file to the CS Entry folder on the device. Step 1. Creating the PFF file. Running the application on Windows will automatically create the PFF file in your data entry application folder. Step 2. Creating the pen file. Select File, Publish Entry Application from the File menu, and select Save. This will create the pen file. Step 3. Copy the PFF and the pen file to the CS Entry folder on the device. We can use a USB cable to connect the device to the computer. Set up the folder for the application within the CS Entry folder on the device. In this example, the application is in the mycapi_intro folder of the CS Entry folder on the device. After we've copied the PFF and the pen files, we are ready to execute the application on the device. Tap on CS Entry to launch CSPro CAPI Data Entry. Select the application to open. In this case, it will be mycapi_intro. Once the application is open, start adding new cases by tapping on Start New Case. We begin with household number 1. So I enter 1 for the household number and tap Forward. We enter a name in the name field. I enter the name Fred. Tap Next. The application asks for sex. Is Fred male or female? Tap on the appropriate choice, then on Next. Note that the name Fred is in the question text. This is because we are using a fill for name, percent name, close percent. The next question we see is relationship. What is Fred's relationship to the head of household? In this case, Fred is the head of household, so we select head of household and tap Next. We enter Fred's age. Let's say it's 56. Tap Next. Can Fred read or write with understanding in any language? Let's say yes. Tap Next, and we are back at the name field. The next person is Wilma. Tap the Next button. We go through the same set of questions. Is Wilma male or female? Tap on Female. I tap Next to go to the next field and continue to add the remaining household members. When I am done, I will leave the name field blank. This tells the CSPro application that I am done entering the members of the household. The application displays the question, "Are you finished entering household members?" with two possible responses. Continue entering household roster or end household roster. I will choose End Household Roster. I am done with data entry for this household. This tutorial has shown the basics of CAPI data entry in CSPro. Please view the CSPro Helps for more information on using CAPI in CSPro.